You know I wrote a book, right? It's called Buy a Game, and it's free. Click the link down there. You got it.
StayAllDay.com.
I know there are some people out there, maybe you, maybe somebody you know, maybe somebody you've heard, who don't, they're not fans of the exotic entertainment industry. Me personally, actually, I'm going to get to me personally in a second. There's some people who are not fans of the industry. They don't like people who strip. They think it might be something wrong with people who strip. They are just completely against the industry itself. They don't think the money that's made in that industry is good. They think people who patronize those places, something's wrong with them. People who work in those places, something's wrong with them. People who own those businesses, must be something morally and character-wise wrong with those people. Me personally, I don't have anything against the stripping industry. I don't strip myself. I know some people who do strip. I have had some friends who stripped. I actually dated some people who stripped. I don't patronize the stripping industry. I don't go to strip clubs. I don't spend any money in strip clubs. But I don't have anything against people who do, male or female, who are in the industry. The thing is, this is the number one thing that I was talking about yesterday on my Snapchat. My Snapchat is at Dre Baldwin. I'm reading this book by Donald Trump. It's called Never Give Up. It's actually the third Donald Trump book that I read. And a lot of times when I start talking about Donald Trump, it'll probably happen right now, people start leaving comments. Are they like, oh, Donald Trump's terrible, Donald Trump's negative, Donald Trump's racist, Donald Trump's a bigot, Donald Trump, you know, he was born with money, so the success he's achieved isn't really real success. And the main thing that I say to people back when they start talking about things like this is what you gotta understand. Even if you hate Donald Trump personally, even if Donald Trump says something that completely offended you, what you have to understand is that that guy knows business. Which means that Donald Trump was given a free course on how to become a billionaire in the real estate industry or how to market and brand yourself. Unless you've already done it and you can do it as well as him or better than him, then you should probably shut the hell up and listen to what the man has to say. Because the book is not about his opinions on Mexicans or how he feels about race or Barack Obama's birth certificate. The book is about not giving up and making a comeback from having setbacks in life and in business. And that's the reason why you have to be able to separate the message from the messenger. That's a very important thing that a lot of people don't get. They let their emotions get in the way of them achieving success in business. Because we all can agree, whether you like Donald Trump or not, the guy knows business. So if he was teaching business and you let your emotions, however you feel about him personally, why you feel some way about somebody who doesn't even know you exist, why you feel any way personally about them, makes no sense whatsoever. But if you let your emotions get in the way of getting the information, then you're blocking the fact, you're blocking your own success. You're letting your emotions get in the way of you doing something. Somebody that you hated personally came to you and offered you a way that y'all both can make $1 million. If all you had to do was cooperate with each other for 30 days, unless you already got $1 million, you should probably entertain the idea. Even though you hate that person personally, you're gonna let your emotions get in the way of your business. And we all know, if any of you have ever talked to anybody who knows business, read a book on business, and know somebody about business, look at this. Do y'all understand that emotions is the number one thing that you leave at the door when you do business? All of you know that, right? If you read the 48 Laws of Power, that's my favorite book by Robert Greene. In the introduction to the book, before he even gets to power law number one thing he says, the number one rule to power is that you must control your emotions. Control your emotional reactions to things. If any of you have ever talked to anybody, read a book by somebody who knows business or is successful in business, please keep tapping the screen for the hearts. I appreciate it. I appreciate that stream of hearts. If you know anybody who's been successful in business, they'll tell you, you must learn to keep your emotions in check, because if you let your emotions control you, you are never going to become successful, because your emotions go all different directions, right? And I made a video about this a long time ago, Weekly Motivation, on my YouTube channel, is this. Emotions, ladies and gentlemen, are like the gas pedal in a car. When you get in a car, you put your foot on the gas, that's the emotions. The emotions will push you forward in whatever direction you want to go. Any strong emotion, anger, fear, jealousy, love, hate, lust, any of those emotions will push you forward strong in whatever direction you're pointing. But the thing is, emotions have no steering wheel. They have no direction. They can go anywhere at any time. Any of you know anybody like that? They just get emotional all the time, and they can go from super happy to super angry to ridiculous to frustrated, and you never know what to expect from that person. Or if any of you ever been that person, y'all know exactly what I'm talking about. Emotions are not the thing that control you, ladies and gentlemen. You have to be controlled by the steering wheel. The steering wheel is your conscious thinking. The steering wheel is the way that you think. So you must learn to think rationally. Don't let your emotions get you in the way or get in the way of you getting something that could actually help you. So all that is said because I know there's some people who are negative about the stripping industry. There are people who are negative about all types of things for no reason. They never worked in the industry. Nobody in the industry has ever did anything wrong to them. They never lost any money there. Nobody in the industry has ever hurt them in any way, physically, emotionally, financially, psychologically. Nobody's ever done anything wrong to them from these areas, but for whatever reason, they're negative about it. Why is that? I have no idea. But what the reason I'm saying all that is to open your mind before I even get into this, is that even if you hate the industry, maybe you know somebody there that you don't like, maybe somebody there, you know, stole some money from you, maybe you went home with a stripper who stole $300 off your drawer and left you sleep in the morning, whatever the situation is, listen, there's some things you can learn about marketing yourself, marketing your brand, and marketing your business from people who are in the stripping industry, and that's what I'm about to share with you right now. So if y'all ready for that, can I see a show of hands, and can I get some hearts, please, as I take a sip of water, because somebody told me they know whenever I drink water, it's going to be a good scope. So can I see a show of hands and some hearts before we get into that? All right, we ready? What's up, Office Shane? How you doing? That happened to you? You had a stripper steal some money from you? All right, well, look, you're going to learn some things to market and brand yourself that you're going to make so much money that don't even matter how much they steal because you always got more coming in. All right, so let's get right into it. Number one thing that you're going to learn from a stripper is this. Leverage what you have to get what you want. Any of you ever seen the movie Players Club with Lisa Ray, Bernie Mac, Jamie Foxx was in it? Number one thing. Leverage, and this is a quote that the strippers was using all the time. I gotta use what I got to get what I want. In life, so many people go through life trying to become successful doing things that they're just not good at. Doing things that they have no talent at, no skill, no natural inclination, and no ability. So they struggle trying to get good at something that they have no natural ability for, and it takes them forever to try to get even average. Number one is leverage what you have. Thank you, Miss Tracy Moss. If you, because here's the thing, and some people say, well, can I make myself into good if I'm not really good at something? Yes, you can, but guess what? It's going to take you a long ass time. It's going to cost you a huge investment in trying to do that. Money, time, effort, energy, emotions. So why don't you focus on the things that you are actually good at? Because every human being has gifts. We all have a gift. We all have some type of skill, some inclination, some ability. The challenge that a lot of people have is, number one, they never find it. And number two, the real reason most people never find it is because they spend their lives trying to force themselves to be something that they are not. They try to force themselves to be good at something that they're just not good at. So what you can learn from the stripping industry is this. What do strippers do? They leverage what they have, which is a nice physical appearance, their ability to dance, their ability to seduce and sell an imagination, sell a dream to the client, and they are able to make money from that. Now, maybe they bought their body. Maybe it's not even theirs, but guess what? They went and made it theirs, and then they go make money from it. So what you need to do is start leveraging what you have to get what you want. Look at the skills that you actually have, the abilities that you actually have in life, and start leveraging those things to get what you want in life. I guarantee once you start leveraging the things that you're actually good at and stop trying to struggle to be good at something that you're not good at, trying to be somebody that you're not, then I guarantee you're going to start seeing a lot more success, and you're going to start seeing that success come a lot quicker. So number one, leverage what you have to get what you want. That's number one. Number two thing that you're going to learn from a stripper is this. Your time is always money. Now, we know that time is the most valuable thing in life, that you don't want to always be trading time for money. But when it comes to you generating income, understand that your time should always be money. If any of you ever been to a strip club, even if you've seen a movie about a strip club, you know how it is. I'll tell you this story one time. When I was like 18, maybe 17, in Philadelphia, which is where I'm from, I went to this party at these people's house. I was with like five of my friends, and my friends was like, yo, these girls we know, they having a stripper party at this house in like North Philly. So and they like, yo, you trying to go? I'm like, all right, whatever. Well, I ain't had nothing else to do. So we go down to this party. It's like five of us. We piled in my man's car. He had a white Acura Legend. I remember that. We piled in my man Rob's car. We go down to this house, and they had these flyers. They showed me the flyer before we even got there. And the flyer said, you know, it's a stripper party. It's going to be this many girls there. It's $5 to get in. And at the bottom of the little flyer, it said this. It said, when your money runs out, so do you. And I love that line. This had to be like 15 years ago, maybe more. But I still remember that one line from that flyer. When your money runs out, so do you. And that was their way of letting you know that if you ain't got no money to tip us while we in here dancing, you ain't gonna be in this party, because every single thing we doing in this party is for you to spend your money. So what does that matter to you? What that matters to you is this. Your time is always money. If any of you ever been to a strip club, you don't go to a stripper and say, hey, let me get a dance for free, right? You gotta pay that stripper for the dance. And if you try to get a dance without paying for it, the bouncer's gonna come over and, you know, politely escort you out, if you know what I'm saying. If you go into the private room, guess what? You gotta pay for that time in the private room. If you wanna have a conversation with that stripper, you probably gotta pay for the time to have that conversation. Every single thing you do when you're dealing with someone in the stripping industry, when they're working, is gonna cost you money every single minute. Is that true or is that not true? Your time is always money. That's something that you need to learn to market yourself, your business, whatever you're doing. So anything that you're doing these days that you're investing time but you're not making money on it, you need to stop doing that. Think like a stripper and stop investing your time and not getting paid for it. Make sure you get paid for everything you do. So number one, leverage what you have to get what you want. Number two, make sure that your time is always money. Do not invest time into anyone or anything if it's not paying you back. Number three, this is number three thing you need about the stripping industry, and this is a very important one. Don't give a damn what other people think of what you're doing. And this is probably the most important one when it comes to the stripping industry, and it's most important when it comes to marketing, branding, and promoting yourself. Stop caring what other people think of you. I used to live in this building that I used to live in. When I first came to Miami, I lived in this condominium building, and it had two towers, one on the left, one on the right, but everybody came in through the same door. And there was a bunch of strippers that lived in that building. Let me tell y'all a funny story. The floor that I lived on, right above me, there was an apartment right above me, a condo right above me, and they had hardwood floors. And you want to know how I knew that they had hardwood floors? Because it was like three strippers who lived in the apartment above me, and every night at like 5 a.m. when I'm waking up, when my alarm is going off, they were coming home from work, and I would hear them walking on the hardwood floors in their apartment in their heels every single night at 5 a.m. I mean, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, weekdays. They were coming home from work at 5 a.m. I'm about to go to work. I'm about to go to the gym and work on my game at 5 a.m. And every morning I would hear them walking on that floor upstairs. And I would get, sometimes I'd get annoyed if before I started getting up that, if I didn't get up that early that day, or my girlfriend at the time would hear it and she would get annoyed like, damn, these bitches always walking in them damn heels. I was like, yeah, they strippers, they're coming home from work. And now, you know what? One thing I respected about them, I never even met them. Let me tell you, that's why this is funny. I never even saw their faces, so I don't even know who they were. But one thing I respected about those females is that they went to work every single night. They never missed a night of work. I mean, every morning when I was waking up at 5 a.m. to get ready to go to the gym, they was coming home from work. I could hear them in their heels every single night. And some nights they would turn on music, and then we had to call security and tell them to turn that shit down. So three things. Let me recap these three things, and then I'm going to take questions from everybody. Number one, leverage what you have to get what you want. Stop trying to be good at something that you're not good at. Use what you're actually good at to achieve success in life. Number two thing that you need to take from a stripper is your time is always money. Do not invest time without getting money for it. Anytime you invest, you get paid for it. Number three, stop giving a damn about what other people think of you. If you're worried about what other people think of you, it will stop you from achieving things in life. It'll stop you from doing things. It'll halt your ideas, and it will block your success, and it will stop you from doing number one and number two, leveraging your time to get money and also doing what you do best. Can I take any questions from anybody right now in the stream? This is Dre Baldwin. You're talking to DreAllDay.com is the website. Well, thank you. Thank you, Dark SC. I'm glad you appreciate this information. For those who don't know me, my name is Dre Baldwin, background pro athlete, played basketball overseas 9 years. Now I'm an author. Just published my 7th book called Dre Philosophy Volume 0. How do you market yourself to university as a player? Use what you got. Can you actually play? Because if you can't, then you can't market yourself. But if you can, show that you can play. Where's your video at? What's going on, Germany? How you feeling? XA Tom. What part of Germany you in? What part of Germany you in, Tom? I've been to Germany. I've been in Stuttgart, been in Wiesbaden, been in Hanover, been in Wolfenbüttel, been in, what's that town called? Reitlingen. When can I start telling myself I got good income? Whenever you decide you got good. If you got game film, then market yourself then. Start using it. Thank you very much, King Son. I appreciate that. You from Stuttgart? Shout out to Stuttgart. Send it to every coach in Canada. Listen, don't try to enlist me to think for you. If you got it as an idea, what's stopping you from doing it? What do you lose by enlisting that idea and actually using it? You don't have to run your ideas by anybody. Go do them and see what happens, and then you can tell somebody else what worked. If you want to know what worked for me, go to my website, DreAllDay.com, and read. I heard there's players playing overseas, they're 50 or so. Do I think that's true? Who cares? Why do I even care if it's true or not? No, I don't know who that is. Who is that you're talking about? Mönchengladbach. No, who is that? Are they American? I got 4,000 videos on YouTube. For those who don't know, my YouTube channel is called WorkOnYourGA.me. Actually, it's this right here. WorkOnYourGA. Just put a dot right here. WorkOnYourGA.me. Teddy said, I appreciate people like you. I started stripping because I needed ends to meet. Well, that's what's up. Listen, hey, Teddy, are you actually a stripper? Teddy, leave a comment. Are you really a stripper, or are you just saying that to be funny? Because I want to use you as an example. Are you actually telling us the truth? You're actually a stripper. So tell me this, Teddy. Did you hear the 3 points that I just shared? Are those accurate? Are those accurate points that I just shared? So ladies and gentlemen, we got Teddy in here. Where are you from, Teddy? Teddy said, I can't see if that's a male or a female. Are you a male or a female, Teddy? And where are you at? Where do you strip at? What club you work at? And what city are you in? All right, so Teddy's a female. She is actually a stripper watching this right now. And I'm asking her, is this actually accurate? Do you leverage what you have to get what you want? Is your time always money? And do you not give a damn what other people think about what you're doing? Are those things all true? And Teddy said they are. I'm trying to find out, Teddy, where you at? Says always money. Okay, Texas. All right, shout out to everybody in Texas. Whether this is real or not, who knows? But listen, I know what I'm talking about. Either way, I know what I'm talking about. So I just published my 7th book. As I said, you can see my books at dreallday.com/Amazon. My next trip to Germany, when I book something out there, when I book an engagement out there, that'll be my next trip. What I think of partnership and business, what I advise to work alone, that's a very broad question. It needs a whole lot more context than that. Yes, I know what I'm talking about. That's what's up, Teddy. I appreciate that. Yes, females do hate regardless. You're right about that. Whether you're a stripper or you're an accountant, the females do hate. You're right about that. So I also do coaching and consulting. I'm a professional speaker. I speak on the topics of marketing, branding, self-promotion. I talk about confidence and mental game stuff, confidence, belief, getting your goals in line with your ambitions and everything. Let me know when I got it. It would be nice to meet you. All right, that's what's up. When you coming to the United States? That's a better question. I'm in South Florida. It's 80 degrees today. What's the temperature in Germany today? I think you should probably come here. Is it easy to find work in the USA? Well, it depends on who you are. You need context. Can I email you to get advice on a personal situation? Yes, you can. My email is dre@dreallday.com. You can also send me a snap at Dre Baldwin. My Snapchat is at Dre Baldwin, DREBALDWIN. I got an online course called Bulletproof Mindset. Bulletproof Mindset. That is in a link in my bio right here on Periscope. That course is beginning April 1st. It is an 8-week course. The reason you want to get it now, because it's in pre-registration for $49 until March 1st. Then the price will go up. Bulletproof Mindset starting April 1st. That's an 8-week course all about the mental game. The complete everything you need about the mental game. If you want to read about it by me, go to dreallday.com/Amazon. Yes, at Dre Baldwin. That is correct. That's my Snapchat name right there. Yes, that's right. The fall. That is correct. So that's an 8-week course. You can register right now. And that course will begin on April the 1st. My book, The Mental Handbook, is on Amazon. The Mirror Motivation on Amazon. The Super You is about confidence. That's on Amazon. Buy a game. You can get for free. Go to dreallday.com. Put your information in the pop-up box. Dre Philosophy Volume 0 is on Amazon. The Insta Philosopher is on Amazon. What's the other book? The Overseas Basketball Blueprint on Amazon. And all this stuff is also on iBooks. dreallday.com/iBooks. Can I take one more question? Here, do I have anything about hope? What do you mean by hope? Teddy, what do you mean by hope? Do I have anything about it? I got content about everything. I am the number one content producing individual alive. That's between video and written content. I produce more content than any individual person out there. Say, don't do anything for free. I get a lot of relationship advice on my broadcast, however. Well, your people are paying you. People are paying attention. If you're broadcasting and they watching, they're paying attention. You understand what I'm saying? You have cancer and you're losing hope and faith. Well, I don't specialize in that, but you should watch my weekly motivation series on YouTube. I got 280 videos. It's all motivation. You watch all 280 of them, I guarantee you will feel 1,000 times better after you watch them all. All right, I appreciate that. Ladies and gentlemen, hit me on Snapchat. Y'all want to talk more at Dre Baldwin. I will be there for the rest of today. Work on your fucking game. DreAllDay.com. Make sure you get my first book, Buy a Game. It is free. Click the link right here below in the video description. I'm on all your favorite social media platforms, Snapchat, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Periscope. All the links are right down here below. It's either Dre Baldwin or Dre All Day on each one of those sites. And make sure you are subscribed. Hit that subscribe button down there and the thumbs up like button. Subscribe so you catch all the new content. I work on your game. Dre All Day.